You want me to grab a handful of moss from what looks to be a hungry pack of piranha?
Yeah, and they are hungry.
They haven't ate.
I didn't feed them today. But I also didn't plan on anybody's hands going in there.
God. I need the towel for my arm.
That
wasn't a fart.
It's because of your weight.
You have to go in much further. That'll likely be good.
Going on a safari.
That's enough fire. Then you have to reach in.
Reach in and put the moss here.
No. Take the lid off.
Oh. I thought I would just sneak in.
And then when you grab the moss, put it here.
Okay.
And then like kind of like gauge if that's enough.
And do you think they're gonna bite me?
I don't know.
Oh gosh, we're a little overexposed here.
I don't think there's a lot of meat on the bone. I don't think they'll eat it. Okay. They're all out though.
Okay. Going in. I didn't get very much.
No. Get in further and grab it.
Get in deep. Yeah. I have to do like a sissy squat here. Who's coming what? Over here?
What, a sissy squat? I don't even know what that is.
You don't? Okay, I feel like they're coming. I can't see where they are.
They are coming. they're interested.
They're like, what's that?
Well, the moss is everywhere. I would never have done that.
Something in here tastes different today.
Okay. How much is left? Oh, damn.
God. I'm sorry.
No, go follow the pipe down.
Okay. Just have a little check here where these guys are on their way over.
They're not gonna come get you.
Okay.
They might come get you.
What if one lives in the corner here?
Yeah, there might be. That's more than enough.
Okay.
That is a selfish amount. Everywhere. You have no idea what it's like to grow moss.
I like my wood mossy.
You like your... In order for the moss to be malleable and for you to be able to work with it, my suggestion... My lord, this is a lot. I'm not really a fan of dating anybody that wants to do fish. Like, I hate this. I don't want to give up anything that I do. Anyways, dry it off. Moss wet is relatively sticky, and this isn't cheap moss either. Like, look at this. This is luscious.
It is lush. Wow.
This is gorgeous. So pick out your favorite piece of wood.
I feel like we can all agree that this requires moss, and yeah. It makes a good headband.
Oh Lord.
Sorry.
So start out by taking a piece of thread and tying it on the wood in a knot.
Okay.
Take as much moss as you think you can cover it with and squeeze it down. Moss is fluffy. Moss is going to want to go everywhere. Now that the thread is tied to the wood, you're going to want to go
totally
around it over and over and over again.
I totally did all of this all on my own. Professional moss boss here.
It's going to float. Like 100% because it's going to float. You just let it go. So the 700-gallon prawn aquarium is our source of moss and where we like to start our wood out. Tamara actually did 3 moss logs, if you can kind of see them. One there, one kind of there, and one over here. The moss is growing. They did eventually sink after a couple of weeks, or maybe it was 3 weeks they sunk, and now the moss is kind of growing, and obviously the piranha are doing well, but all 3 are for her aquariums that I donated to her here in the basement of my house. If you don't remember, these are a pair of 180-gallon aquariums, TV in the middle, so you can kind of sit there and watch TV and enjoy your aquariums. This is not real. It's styrofoam. I did a video on how to build all this, but a sheet of styrofoam. I used a heat wire to carve the
grooves out to kind of make it look like brick, and then a heat gun to kind of give it texture, and then simply painted it. Very simple and easy to do. She wants to do the moss logs in one tank, and I'm not sure what she's doing with the other, but one of her main goals is to set up a 180-gallon beta aquarium housing several males and a ton of females. And if the tank is set up and scaped correctly, that's going to be possible in a 180-gallon aquarium because it's simply big enough. A lot of the times we don't want to put two male bettas in the same tank, but also a lot of times we don't dedicate a 180-gallon aquarium to a beta. So I'm excited to see what she does there. Luckily, these tanks are in the house, and it'll keep her in here more, and keep her out of the gallery and her hands off my moss and my tanks. And with a little bit of luck, maybe one day her moss log will look similar to mine. However, she will be documenting those tanks on her own channel. If you don't know, Tamara now has her own channel where she's vlogging and kind of showing what she's up to throughout the day, but she does venture out to the gallery a lot and spoil a lot of future videos that nobody has seen the content for, but she insists on coming out and checking things out. So if you want to subscribe to her and follow her along for her 280-gallon tank builds, I'll leave a link in the description. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. I'll see you guys in the next one.